The Warriors shook off their sluggish Game 1 to defend home court in a big way against the Celtics, letting the guys in green know that they were prepared to do whatever it took to defend
our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our...
One reason the game was so close until the end of the third wasn't because Boston was playing particularly well. It was because the Warriors were missing a lot of shots close into the basket. This can signal two things. Either the Celtics are going to fix their miscues and stop these shots from happening, or the Warriors will eventually start exploiting the defensive breakdowns. Check the matchups Ime Udoka wants to start with. Smart is guarding Curry, but interestingly, they have Robert Williams on Wiggins. A simple screen from Curry gets a mismatch, but watch how Tatum steps up to switch before Curry gets the ball. However, Tatum lets Curry right into the lane, worse, into the middle, where he gets the off-foot floater off, but Williams is able to knock it away. The Warriors get pistol action with the handoff into ball screen out top, and it allows a downhill attack for a left-handed layup. Again, another beautiful block, but can the defense continue to make great plays like this? The Warriors want to attack Williams in the pick and roll, but watch how Horford pre-switches to give them a more mobile defender to switch on to Curry. And it just about worked until Draymond doesn't take the bait, smartly getting it back to Curry in the corner, where he promptly blows by Horford for an easy layup. There's a lot of contact to the midsection that helped this one miss, but they did get it back on the Brown push-off. In transition, the Celtics get cross-matched, but they don't mind Smart guarding Wiggins one bit, until the part where he gets beat to the baseline, gets right to the basket, but smokes the layup because he banked it a little too hard. It was Klay's turn in transition, and his threat to shoot keeps Brown close enough so that a crossover can get Klay by him. But Klay was simply off all night, and he cold blows this wide open one. And the Celtics again rely on an exceptional play by Derek White to stop what was a certain 2 points, as Poole hits him with a smitty. Watch how he taps the left foot, lifts it, then replaces it into a split to accelerate back to the hoop. He uses the off-foot inside hand layup to cut off White's angle, and it's possible White blocked this after it hit the backboard, meaning a goaltend, but it was such a great recovery, let him have the block. This continued as Brown foolishly tries to keep in front of the ball handler by sliding his feet instead of turning his hips and running. Klay's action on the weak side occupies all three help defenders, and all he's got to do is lay this thing in. What was most amazing about how the Warriors ended this game 10 minutes early is that they didn't even go on their big run until there was about 4.5 minutes left in the third. In about 5 minutes of game time, the Warriors pushed a small 6-point lead to a whopping 29 points. With the Warriors trying to attack Horford again, the Celtics attempt to do something called nexting, where the weak side wing comes over to help on the ball defender, allowing Horford to stay with the roll man. However, if he lets the pass to the wing get there this easily, there is simply no hope for the defense, as you cannot outrun a pass to basketball.
Our house, it has a crowd. There's always something happening, and it's usually quite loud.
You could tell their home crowd was giving the Warriors a boost on both ends, and there's nothing like it when your team performs well in a must-win game. And you can be part of that celebration with NBA Top Shot. NBA Top Shot is the ultimate way for NBA fans to show off their fandom for their favorite teams and players. You can build your collection of some of the best moments from the NBA season, like DeMar DeRozan's second consecutive three-point game-winning buzzer beater against the Wizards, and owning moments can help you gain access to once-in-a-lifetime NBA fan experiences, as Top Shot fans have gotten to toss alley-oops up to slam dunk champion Obi Toppin and eaten dinner with first-round picks the night before they got drafted. I love the anticipation of opening a pack to find out which moments you got, but they've also got challenges that earn you moment rewards and let you get in on the action during a night of NBA games. The place to start is by clicking on my special link, sign up for a $9 starter pack, and Top Shot will give you $20 back to buy a moment in the marketplace. See what you got with NBA Top Shot. While the Celtics were the number one ranked defense in the regular season, the Warriors have taken their D to a whole nother level, and Steph Curry was a big part of it. The flare screen for Tatum doesn't get him open, White doesn't attack his advantage, and watch how Curry won't let himself be screened. Now the shot clock is an extra defender. However, Curry was forced onto Horford. Nothing they can do about this long rebound, but watch what Curry does as Horford tries to back him down. He's physical, alters Horford's angle, and why is Grant Williams standing here? It allows his man Porter to easily help, and while this deal might have looked easy, it's next level IQ to anticipate the pass and just knock it to a teammate for the turnover. The Celtics are sensing this game slipping away, so they run horns with Tatum in the corner. Wiggins was excellent all night, refusing to be screened off his primary assignment, recovering to prevent a quick catch and shoot, and I'm sure in Tatum's mind, he's the man who has to get the buckets for his team. But he takes too much time with the ISO, Wiggins is right there in his grill, and he can't hit this. More stellar defense by Curry. This was his best possession as he pressures Pritchard, angling his feet to not let him get out of the corner, and he will not allow him to get middle no matter what. Watch how he crosses his left foot over his right in order to be fast enough to stop penetration. Wiggins does offer some half-hearted help, but now it's Draymond's turn to accelerate into a closeout that forces White to lift both feet and put them back down before dribbling. And if you play with fire long enough, you get burned. This double ball screen catches Draymond as the fullback, blocking for a screen pass, and it prevents Horford from stepping up to meet the best shooter of all time. Not even a tough contest from behind could have any effect on this guy. What makes Draymond so great is his early anticipation to be in help. He's guarding basically a non-threatened Tice, so he can ignore him to help Wiggins from being beaten on the shot fake. Curry is in the right position to close out on the left wing. Porter was a step slow, closing to Pritchard, but the open shot from deep misses, and you'd have missed this if you blinked. They went to attack Tice in the pick and roll with Curry, and even though Tice starts with both feet above the three-point line, that's just not good enough, as Steph can rise up from the hash mark on a contested shot, and it drops clean through to begin the rout. Let's quickly look at the differences in rotations between game 1 and 2. You can see Kerr added more minutes for Curry and slashed Poole's and Klay's minutes pretty significantly. While Klay wasn't very good at all in this game offensively, culminating in the strangest attempt here with his offhand, Poole was much better than he was in game 1, helping hit the last three nails deep into the Celtics' coffin. They run motion weak from the Spurs playbook as Poole enters the ball to the wing and shallow cuts to the weak side. Curry screens for Looney to get his man behind the play, but the Celtics just switch this, and on the switch, check the wicked hesitation off the between-the-legs crossover move. This forces Tice to help, Tatum should have been there on a sink and fill, and Looney gets the layup. I love how Wiggins simply refuses to switch off of Tatum no matter what the Celtics try to do to shake him off. This kind of harassment was happening the entire game, and a big reason why he was only 2 of 10 from inside the arc. The Celtics continue to take too much time to get into any meaningful attack, leaving not much time to finish this nice shot fake and drive by White. However, Looney has been their anchor for years, and he uses perfect verticality to thwart the White shot until the shot clock expired. Then, the pool party got started. All his friends were invited, as Tice does a perfect job of a tough situation, switching out of the pick and roll, being three steps above the three-point line, but the jab step to end the dribble gets him a little space as Poole makes you shake your head based on the distance of the shot, but it just doesn't matter. While the deciding factor of Game 1 was Derek White and Al Horford combining to shoot 11 for 16 from 3, they came back down to earth a bit, and even though they catch Wiggins dropping too far, it wasn't the first time he made this mistake, they survive it, and it directly leads to this end-of-quarter heave from half-court, and when this went in, it effectively ended the game 12 minutes early.
Was our castle and our-